When you look at market research coming out of the industry, you tend to see the workstation segment or the gaming segment, and it's treated as though those two segments don't cross over, that there's no gamer who wants to create as a hobby or no creator who wants to game as a hobby.
At AMD, we believe that creators and gamers and consumers really aren't different people.
We call those people prosumers, people who game and create and want to do that on one system.
With Ryzen 7 series of processors, there's not a need to pick either workstation and prosumer or gaming. You can do both.
With performance that's ready for games today, and 8 cores and 16 threads that's ready for creative apps today.
Video editing, rendering, maybe some 3D modeling, a little bit of code compilation. These are all things that ends up being mainstream now because everybody wants to be a programmer, everybody wants to be a game designer, everybody wants to make their kids' submission for Bandcamp look perfect. So these are all the things that need more cores and threads, and our great new price points for Ryzen 7 bring professional level workstation performance to consumer pricing.
I've had hands-on time with 3ds Max, with Handbrake, with Blender, with PavRay, so that's a cross-section of 3D modeling, ray tracing, video encoding, and the results that I'm seeing are really, really good. And that tells me that the Ryzen 7 family of processors is well equipped to make that transition from game to creation or creation to game. And so a user doesn't have to have two separate systems, their gaming PC and their creation PC.
It's all available in the same product, on the same platform, that's scalable. So even if you start off as a gamer or just a mainstream performance computer, you can upgrade simply in the socket and you're there into the prosumer space. Personally, getting hands-on with the first Ryzen 7 process has been amazing. I've been able to do more things faster, both from a gaming perspective, 4K and high resolution, or just editing videos and making the fun little movies we make for life in general with the kids. All of those things are, you know, easily 30% faster when compared to my old machine, which is just amazing, especially considering that if I were to try and upgrade to that level of performance, then it would be over $1,000, and my cost to change here is well under half of that.